Hi, let's talk about hypothesis verification methods. There are several of them, but technically, first of all, we need to pretest hypothesis. Possibly we need to decline or remove it before start. And rest two, A/B testing and experiment, we use for statistically significant results. So if we would like to use to build data-driven company, A/B testing and experiments provide us real results that we can prove and learn from them. Other ones just help us to do not start unnecessary experiments. So let's go deep. For example, research. For example, we can explore existing data. For example, earlier our product worked like 3 seconds. Like we generate website in 3 seconds. Now we start generating in 1 second. When we analyze results, when it was 3 seconds and now we have 1 second, we can see that no metrics increased. For example, we have no more registration, we have no less retention. So nothing changed. We increased from 3 to 1 second. So it provides us a knowledge. Should we increase to 0.5 seconds? So our earlier knowledge can provide us information that we don't need to do test here. Next one is behavior analysis. We can use, for example, we can take webvisor and analyze heat maps, take last 20 sessions and look carefully if customers have problems there. If there are no problems, we don't need to run hypothesis. And degradation testing. For example, let's say our product works, generate website in 3 seconds. And we think if it would be 0.5 seconds, it will be very nice. But it's very difficult technically to increase speed 5 times. Well, possibly we can decrease speed, maybe make it 30 seconds. And it's much easier for us, just make delay. And when we see that when we make it worse and nothing changed, it means we don't need to test hypothesis. So if worse doesn't change metrics, it means providing a better results should also do not increase our metrics. For example, customer development. So firstly, we need to test, does problem exist? So if there are no problem, we don't need to run hypothesis. We also need to test if solution exists, if our solution, fits the problem, if our solution solves the problem. If our solution does not solve the problem, why we need to run the hypothesis? We need to write right solution. We need to find right solution and test it. Only right solution. Why we need to test and spend time for wrong solution? And also surveys. When you order through Booking or Viber, or Uber or Airbnb, you need to provide ratings. And of course, rating provides lots of information for owners and for other customers. So the idea just good or bad ratings can prevent something or can say that here you can, here you need to analyze the situation much more. As Amazon or Booking, it's also data-driven companies. They do, 100 or 1,000 tests every week, and ratings really help them. And sometimes if you see that all, 100 hotels have nice rating, we don't need to test with them. We need to test only with that one that has bad ratings. Also UX tests. What is important with UX tests, we do not collect opinions. We collect only if our product feature, pattern achieve needed results. So we provide to our potential customer just, please find this button. Please, make website. Please calculate the salary. Please do something. And he use the interface. If we ask him about his opinion, oh my God, he's an expert. he tries it. Oh, you need to make a button bigger. You need blah, blah, blah. But we need exact answer. Did our interface solve the problem? And it's very important because wrong question, you provide wrong results, your product go right, wrong direction. And also there are hallway or corridor test when you just, I don't know, print several pages and show it to customer, maybe ever take your phone and show something and to people who going through the hallway. And it's really very, very nice way. And by the way, if you ask 5 people, usually statistically, you will find 85% of results, of problems. So 5 people provide you more than 80% of problems. So it's really fast method. Also, prototype testing. Sometimes you can, make prototype and also test with your customers, with your potential customers. And by the way, if you would like to change interface, for example, when you change interface, customers need sometimes to use it very easily. For example, when you change interface, customer comes here one time, second time, third time, and only then customer start like using it as a daily user, very, very comfortable. So the idea just you provide them prototype and ask them for do the action, specific action. Also, no opinions. Provide the prototype. Please, customer, do specific actions. And also, nice ways, ghost button. Also, you can call them fake buttons or placebo buttons. The idea is just buttons that do nothing. For example, we test, we would like to add emails to our service, and we just put fake buttons. Pay €1 for emails, and we get income every day from that button. So we refund the money but the idea we got understanding that our customers would like to have this service and pay for that. And what is important that it's like fake button or placebo button. You can just write, oh, sorry, this service is not available in your country, or sorry, we're just developing this feature, we'll inform you when it will be done. But it saves lots of time and you understand two things. Sometimes if customer have needs for that service, and also sometimes you put button, nobody use it. It means you do not need to develop the service. Can you imagine? Everybody wait for that. You put the button, nobody clicks it. It means nobody would use this feature. Okay. Also MVP. MVP could be done for whole product, for function, or ads campaign. For example, you can do, let's say, run campaign, in Germany. If it succeeds, we can expand countries. For example, we start with small region or with several regions, better. And then if you succeed, you come wide. What is important, if you would like to test with bloggers and you take one blogger with one message and doesn't work or it works, you can have you get bad knowledge, so you will get bad, you will do bad next steps. So if you test with bloggers, 10, 50 bloggers, provide them several messages, test with them. So you need to have statistically significant result. What next? So ABC testing. As the idea, just there are split testing. Split testing is, by the way, most powerful because for example, you run at the same time A and B test. And for example, if you decrease traffic or traffic is very big or test is too long, you still split, so you have similar audiences. There are several advices here. Do not run long tests. For A-B testing, it's still valid long test, but still avoid to do long tests if it's not A-B testing. And of course, it's need traffic because when you split, you need double traffic. I will explain it in a separate video about Evan Miller, how much traffic you need. Also, you can use multivariate testing when you provide, let's say, 50 results or maybe 10,000 results. But in that case, you need lots of traffic. Because if you, let's say, person with image one, like there will have one purchases, people who saw picture one, we have three purchases who saw pictures two, and blah, blah, blah. We don't know which picture is better. So we need mathematical proof that it works. And in that case, it's also not very easy from mathematical side to run test correctly. So to run test, it's very easy, but to get nice results and understandable results and do some, get some correct knowledge, it really takes time. And also false positive, like A testing. Sometimes when you test, you get lots of problems. And for example, you get bad data. So sometimes you need to do A and A. For example, you split A and A and see if it provides the same results. Because sometimes, for example, your, I don't know, splitter headers, for example, mobile get one user and desktop has other user and different audience. Technically, it's different audiences and it's also different devices and you get bad results. So for double checking, it's really sometimes experts run A tests. There are also lots of other tests. For example, you run A-B test, and then, for example, you do A test, then you run B test, and like see if metric changes, and then you return to A again to understand if previous interface provide previous results. Because sometimes when you do experiment, you change from one to other. You have trouble because you do experiment, you change interface and new traffic comes and you're dead. So in that case, AA test really can help you a lot. And I really recommend when you do tests, do not play with colors or with like do something extremal, like some big difference, one button, two buttons, big title related with background, like really titles can provide you really good results. Don't test with something that do not provide you potential income. Test with things that provide you like that can increase the metrics 100-200% just at the beginning. It will save lots of your time. And also experiment. Experiment also, it's very nice method. Of course, I also recommend it to do when you have big traffic. And of course, you have when you do experiments, you start with one audience, then you have second audience. For example, older audience works with old product, new audience works with new product. So you need to compare cohorts. Cohorts is means like users related to the time, like user segment related to the time. Let's take users who was on the pricing page from January 1 to January 30. And take users who had new pricing, who were on the website from, I don't know, 1st of March till 30th of March, let's say. And compare what is how fast they buy, how long they stay, etc. Also, we can do some very easy experiments. For example, we can test results. For example, we do not have a feature. We can test advertise it. For example, we don't have, let's say, something artificial intelligence in our product. And I said, we advertise. Artificial intelligence will provide a website for you. So we test with this feature. If people click on it, we develop the feature. If people do not click, no need. Or for example, let's say we would like to add who is service to our website. And we just see how many inquiries in Google. We just put some ads, see how much cost traffic for us and see if people click. And we calculate, okay, if cut traffic costs like this, if we can get enough traffic, so we can develop the feature. And of course, fast changes. Sometimes it's just faster to make the change than sometimes it's really faster to make change and to get the results than do A-B testing or other type of testing. Yeah, so it's when you run the hypothesis, it's very important. Like, so it's one of the hypotheses how we form it. For example, if we translate our FAQs to Lithuanian, then we will double traffic from Google because user prefer local language. So user possibly search in local language, blah, blah, blah. So we analyze results before. So we take the year, analyze the month's average. Then we start the hypothesis. We see when it started January 3. We need long time to, so it was graded, and that the hypothesis has start time and also due time. Also, hypothesis has testing method like experiment, and what type of funnel, and how easy to start, because we need to translate, by the way. So, what is important? It should be for hypothesis clear start and finish, of course, responsible person. Of course, understandable testing method, and start collecting the data. So, thank you for your time, and see you on the next video.